Okay. Maybe we can play a more fair game of Magic this time around. Do I want to keep this hand? Do we believe in the heart of the cards? I believe in the heart of the cards. I believe. We got some blue cantrips that give us redraws as well. We have a turn to negate. If my opponent plays a one drop, I can repeal. If my opponent's playing a control deck, then it's really bad for me. Repealing that feels bad. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Just the naturals. We call that the naturals. Old Man of the Sea. Any opportunity you get to resolve a planeswalker, I think you should pretty much do every time. Or most of the time. Oh, like what my opponent did just there. The question is my opponent gonna Old Man Main Face? They should. They should Old Man Main Face, yeah. Darn you, smart opponent. What happens if I give it flying? I just want to make another token anyways. Just want to flood the board here. Have something that can attack the Gideon. Battle of Blue-White Midrange. Let's go. Gideon versus Elspeth. Aren't they friends? Okay. Does my opponent now take my Whirler Rogue? Okay. What do I want to do? Definitely don't want to play Monastery Mentor because my opponent can steal it. Kind of want to bounce that Oblivion Ring. Old Man of the Sea is a giant pain, though. If I bounce the Oblivion Ring, end of turn. That's how I can kill Gideon. So basically, my plan is to try to kill Gideon. If I bounce Oblivion Ring end of turn, I will be able to then untap and play Reflector Mage and Old Man of the Sea. Then use the Elspeth to finish off the Gideon. Then the O-ring will come back into play. But at some point, I can snap cast or Mage Repeal. I think my opponent probably just takes a Thopter here. Yeah, Gideon on three. Slow and steady, folks. Right. If my opponent basically has some kind of counter spell, then we're in a lot of trouble, but Emyria Angel. Okay, this is gonna be rough. Okay. We still have outs. It's aggressive. Actually, that attack's totally fine. Maybe one. Yeah, that's probably what I would do. Yeah, basically, I feel like if my opponent has a counter there, we're just dead. But I'm not gonna lie, this Parallax Wave is pretty good. I can hold it or just use it right now. If I use it right now, I can use it on all of these. It doesn't seem bad. So the alternative is to play Reflector Mage, targeting Old Man of the Sea. If I play Reflector Mage targeting Old Man of the Sea, my opponent will then attempt to steal something with Old Man of the Sea. But that's not gonna really matter. I can make the soldier unblockable, then give it flying. But then we take a lot of damage. Oh, not that much. And then we can play the Parallax Wave to clean up the board a little bit afterwards. And Reflector Mage is pretty good at blocking the knights, at least. It doesn't really matter what my opponent steals. If they steal a Thopter, I can just tap both of them to make a soldier unblockable. Actually, I don't even need to do that. It really doesn't matter. My opponent can steal anything, and I will get that creature back. Then I can use the Elspeth again to finish off the Gideon. We have dealt with Gideon. And the Elspeth can't even die to the flyers currently. We have three blockers on the ground, but my opponent only has four power in the skies. I imagine my opponent is going to cast Oblivion Ring again here. You don't want the Elspeth to get out of hand. They cannot play Old Man of the Sea, which is nice. It gives me a turn to kind of try to play my things. Again, playing Parallax Wave doesn't seem bad. I have two creatures that's really good with Parallax Wave, and I can also remove some creatures on my opponent's side as well. So it seems like a good way to kind of get the tempo back on my side. But then how do we deal with the Old Man of the Sea afterwards? That's the question. Interesting. Okay, I see. Oh yeah, that totally works. Yeah, that definitely just kills Elspeth, right? They're all attacking Elspeth. Okay. Let me think. Kind of bottlenecked on mana here. All right, we got rid of 7 power on the side of our opponent, and we get to remove a Whirl of Rogue. Not bad. Oh, wow. Feel like my opponent just has a better version of my deck. If I remove that, it just comes back. Yeah, you got it. I mean, yeah, how are we coming back from this? I can't Snapcaster or anything. I wonder what the black splash is for. Maybe Lingering Souls, Vindicate? I wonder if I just want a Force Spike just to make a token. This is just snowballing out of control. Yeah, I don't really see a way out of this, but let's keep fighting. Yeah, okay. Too many cards, too many cards. I guess Jitte is a good way to maybe try to get our opponent there. Spell Queller too. The question is, do I want to add the red here or do I just want to keep it the same? It does give me answers to Oblivion Ring, although I currently do have an answer to Oblivion Ring. I think I'm probably the aggressor here. So I don't think I want to like slow down too much. Granted, like my creatures don't generally die in this matchup. So maybe I don't want the Karmic Guide. But I also don't have that many answers to, well, let's see. I had this. I'm looking at like answers to Consecrated Sphinx. I guess those four. Yeah, this is fine. I think I just want to. This is like the most aggressive version of my deck for the most part. So I'm just. Again, I need to curve out. And as I think our opponent's late game is a little better than ours. Actually, you know what? My opponent did have Old Man of the Sea. It's possible I wanted the red just for that. Maybe on the draw. Again, I still have some answers. Right, give me a Plains here. I would have killed for this. Hallowed Fountain would have been so good for us. Tempo. All right. Really need a plane. I think if we draw planes, we can legitimately win this game. If not, it's gonna be hard. Maybe my opponent plays. No, playing Gideon is really bad because I have a Cloudscape coming in. Some kind of removal spell? Restoration Angel? Vendilion Click. All right. I mean, I guess this is one of those like awkward spots where my opponent doesn't really want me to play my double white cards, so they might just. No, they got rid of the Elspeth. Okay. I still have a chance to draw a white source, please. Nope. Wow. I would like at any point in the draft if I saw a Hallowed Fountain or a Tundra, I would have just taken it so fast. Blue white, just so many double blue, so many double white effects. I put a new about Spell Pierce, right? I feel like they ran that out to like play out something else. So that's why I played the Spell Pierce, because my opponent knows about that one. It is awkward if I draw planes though, because then I can place that, but. Right, Stoneforge is an okay draw. And I'm gonna keep up the negate because that was kind of fishy playing that out. Actually, they have Flicker Wisp though. Eh, whatever. It's kind of awkward because like my opponent ran out Gideon into my Spell Pierce, so I want to keep up negate. And I feel like if my opponent has a big sweeper effect, they'll play into it. Oh, maybe this is a Restoration Angel. What is this? End of turn. Okay. It is a Restoration Angel. All right. Well, rip Jite. What should I do here? The Restoration Angel, the sizing on the Restoration Angel is just, it just makes it so hard for us right now. I mean, we can just try to go white, I guess. Yeah, perhaps I should have just played the Jite that turn. I was just so afraid of something that my opponent could follow up there. Like, let's say my opponent played a Day of Judgment or something. We'd be in so much trouble. With just like a naked GTA on the battlefield. Well, that's actually not that bad, because we have the Karmic Guide. The question is, what do we actually get back with this? Do we get Stoneforge Mystic? Or do we get Angel of Invention? This just puts so much more onto the battlefield. Yeah, I'll just go with the Angel of Invention. I do like my opponent's deck. It's kind of the deck that I wish I had. Vendilion Click and Restoration Angel. Those are like the tempo-y blue-white cards you want in your deck. Huh. I'm gonna remand that. Wow, all the blowouts. All right. Do I have a good attack here? If I attack with everything, my opponent what blocks Angel of Invention, and then I have a 2-2 and a 1-1. I could repeal Karmic Guide for added value, or just attack with Servo. Okay, I'm happy with that trade. Consecrated Sphinx. Credit Sphinx, compulsive research on burial rights. Alright. I think we're looking okay here. Yeah, so now if my opponent taps out to play Consecrated Sphinx, I can just play Elspeth, jump my Angel of Invention, and we have two lethal attackers. My opponent can maybe look for an answer by casting Compulsive Research, but maybe their best bet is to just play the Consecrated Sphinx, because Unburial Rites doesn't do that much. And I play the probe on my turn because, of course, the Consecrated Sphinx. So I kind of have to hope that my opponent doesn't draw Supreme Verdict. Alright. Alright. Got that one. Days, huh? Okay. So, do we want to add these cards? Possibly? Maybe even this card? Geist might be pretty bad on the draw. See, many of these cards don't seem great. This is kind of slow. This makes... These are both value. Maybe Master of Waves is also not great. Like, I like Mentor, Whirl of Rogue, Angel of Invention, Looter, Stoneforge Mystic, Snapcast. Like, I like those. I like that set. Reflecting Mage is probably fine. So, if we do this, maybe I cut Spell Pierce. Like, my opponent had just mostly creatures. I mean, they do have Gideon, so it is nice there. They have Compulsive Research. I guess it's still okay. And then this is like our cheap counter magic suite. And then we have this. So I'm trying to figure out what I want to not play. Let's add the red. Can also add another mountain, I think. Alright, yeah, let's go ahead and cut Spell Pierce. I'll get my opponent with Force Spike. And you know what? Let's keep it real loose. Mostly because I can't figure out what to cut last minute. And I want to submit. All right, we've slowed down a lot on the draw. Hopefully this ends up working out for us. Just gonna go ahead and fetch my island, thin out my deck. Oh wait, I have a Sacred Foundry. Yeah, I'm still gonna get island. Blue, blue, blue. Ooh. Not bad. Also not bad. I think we should just jam. Now I'm just gonna hardcast the Jitte. Wow, Our opponent's stuck on two lands. That gives us hope. Angel of Serenity, okay. So they could have like a reanimation effect. Alright, well, if they're going to discard that, I'm actually just going to keep up Negate here instead of equip Jitte. Because they could have an Exhume or something, or Animate Dead. Spellqueller. This is really awkward. I should have equipped onto the Stormforge Mystic then, I guess. I totally forgot about that. But I want to save my mentor. Gah. No GT counters for me. Mistakes were made. Alright, so Supreme Verdict is certainly a thing that I need to be mindful of. Council's Judgment. And what do I want to do with this? I'm going to negate it. I guess my opponent can daze me. Okay. All right. Bye bye, Monastery Mentor? Jitte? Okay, Jitte. Alright, let's play Outpost Siege. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'll just do cons. I could have remanded it too for more damage. Like, my opponent can still just Supreme Verdict here. That's what it feels like. Oh, no. All right. That's not Supreme Verdict at all. Did we get it? Wow. Beat a mana screwed opponent. That is surprising. Just attack. All right. Monastery Mentor got there. Wow. We did not play this draft especially well. We made a few small errors. In that last game, I should have equipped GT onto Stoneforge Mystic. That also plays around repeal on a token if my opponent had it. So I should have done that because I should have been mindful of the Spellqueller. Which means I would have had two counters on Jitte. Ultimately, it didn't matter because my opponent resolved Council's Judgment on my Jitte, but still, that's a little thing. Really wish we had a few more blue and white sources. We were trying to set up to maybe get opposition, but of course, you know, that's like a mythic rare. It's hard to get. But the deck played out okay. I think generally the control decks are going to be a little bit better, although admittedly, I don't really like blue-white control that much. I like... The problem with blue-white is you don't have enough cheap interaction in terms of removal. You have Path to Exile, Swords to Plowshares. You really don't have that much. So I like delving into a third color a lot of the time for additional Planeswalkers, because that's how you win a lot of games. And there's not enough ways to get ahead on cards than just straight blue-white a lot of the time. So, you know, often I'll splash a Johnny, Nahiri, cards like that. Or, you know, I like going, for example, blue-red. You still have sweepers in red, but you have the outs to draft like something like Splinter Twin and draft a good deck there as well. So this was Legacy Cube Draft. I will probably try to record another one if it's available on Magic Online. I've been having a lot of fun just because it's Cube Draft. And I just love any version of Cube as long as it's out. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you all next week.